Yvette Avery is a middle-class mom from Atlanta who puts family first.
Being a mother is definitely a struggle because in the beginning I was a single mother for the first few years that I was, you know, had my kids. And before I moved here as a single mom and was, you know, single for a few years. So doing it on your own has always been a big challenge. But I've always been one to try to face up to the challenges and do everything I can to take care of my family.
When she moved to Atlanta around 2003, she eventually found part-time employment at UPS. And now?
I work on the ramp. I'm a tug driver, also an alternate steward, and a wellness champion on the safety committee.
In 2011, the weight of raising a family forced Yvette to get a second job at Delta Airlines. She says Delta initially had no problems with her working at UPS.
I put it on my application because it wasn't an issue as far as I knew between the companies. So it was on the application when I applied. All of my supervisors over the years always knew that I worked for UPS. It was like common knowledge, especially during busy season at UPS. I would always, you know, decrease my hours and swap out so I could work more at UPS just for those, you know, busy seasons that we had. So it was common knowledge, never an issue over the years.
But management's mood changed when she recently spent personal time helping the IAM organize ramp and gate workers at Delta.
So I started wearing a union pin out at the gates on my uniform, you know, passing out flyers in the break room and being very active out at the parking lot and different other areas, you know, with the union. I was met in the office and told that I had 2 weeks to decide which job that I wanted to keep because all of a sudden UPS and Delta became a conflict of interest after 7 years.
Sadly, Delta dropped a bombshell and fired Yvette.
Still to this day, sometimes it's hard to realize that, you know, the life that you've made and was used to and had to take care of your family, to accommodate your family, is now gone, so it's been very hard.
Yvette believes she was fired for publicly supporting the IAM and says Delta used her employment at UPS as a cover story. Her proof?
To this day, I am working next to people at UPS that still work for both companies. And it's been, you know, people have 20 years of seniority at both companies.
Despite losing her job, Yvette still supports the IAM's organizing drive at Delta. She says the company's culture needs to change.
Understaffing, you know, safety issues there, people getting hurt and not wanting to report it because they're afraid they won't have a job.
According to Yvette, Delta intimidates workers who speak out against the company, especially those who are caught helping the IAM.
So if we're out at the parking lots, we're, you know, being videotaped or pictures being taken of us, if we're out standing where the buses drop off at the airport on what we call landside, we've had, you know, supervisors come out, take pictures of us out there. So people are subject to anti-union videos on a daily basis in the break rooms. Those anti-union flyers are being set in the break room every day.
But Yvette is fighting back. She's volunteering with the IAM's organizing drive, and with the assistance of the union, she filed a complaint against Delta with a national mediation board. Unfortunately, the NMB refused to investigate. But despite all the drama at Delta, Avery says she's not bitter.
Well, I would love to go back to work, actually. I loved my job. I did it well.
She just wants worker fairness at one of the most profitable airlines in the world.
Having a grievance process, having stuff in black and white that you can, you know, count and depend on, being able to retire with a pension, having, you know, security, job security, having security no matter if you're injured on the job, you know that you're just not going to be targeted and kicked to the curb or put to the side because, you know, of what's going on with you. You have, you know, a steward or a representative that can back you and go into any meeting with you with management. So you just have that protection that you do not have unless you have a contract. And hopefully, in the end, I'll be back at work and we'll be, you know, represented by the union and everything will go back to or go to what it needs to be here.